See this menu? It's not built into the iPad, but you can easily add it yourself. And once you do, your iPad will instantly feel faster. This is my action menu shortcut. It lives in the dock, so it's always available. I use it to open my password manager, split screen multiple apps for quick research, switch focus modes, and even start a voice session with ChatGPT. It is fast, it is customizable, and it won't just save you time. It's gonna make your iPad feel like it was built just for you. So grab your iPad and let's set it up. First, open up the Shortcuts app. Then tap the plus in the top right-hand corner. Inside the search bar, type choose from menu and then add it. Now this creates the framework for our shortcut, which is essentially a blank menu tree. Next, rename the first option to passwords. The second option we're gonna change to Safari and Notes. The third option is gonna be desktop, and the fourth one will be intercom. Now I like to add an emoji to each option. This way it makes it a little bit more easier to recognize and scan it at a quick glance. Now next we're gonna wire up each option to an action. We're gonna go ahead and search open app and drag it underneath passwords. We're gonna tap in the password field and you're gonna choose your password manager. I'm using 1Password. This works with any password manager, including Apple's own passwords app. Now next we're gonna search split screen apps on the right-hand side and drag it underneath Safari and Notes. Now I'm calling it Safari Notes because that's what I'm using. You can use any two apps that you want to have opened up in split screen. It doesn't really matter. Now if you tap the arrow down, you'll see that you can also change the window layout from 50-50, 25-75, or 75-25, which is when you hit this, it will actually go ahead and put those windows in their perspective ratios. Now the next option is gonna allow us to open up any specified file location from anywhere on our iPad right here inside of the menu tree. We're gonna search for file and drag it underneath the desktop. Now you can tap on any folder you want. I'm going to search for my actual desktop folder inside of iCloud. It doesn't really matter. Now there is a small quirk here. Even though you've chosen a folder, iPadOS still wants to know how you want to open it. It doesn't really make any sense. So we're gonna go ahead and type in open file, drag it underneath here, and set the variable to file. And we'll choose files as the app. And if you skip this step, your shortcut will not work. So don't skip it, because you'll ask questions why it's not working. Finally, we're gonna go ahead and configure our HomePods to broadcast a message underneath the intercom action. Now, HomePods is what I have in my house. I don't think it works with the Google Homes products. If you don't have either a HomePod or you don't have Apple Home, you can skip this to the timestamp right in the navigation below. Now, search intercom and drag it underneath intercom. Type your message. Doesn't really matter what you want. Dinner's ready, come home. It doesn't really matter, but I'm gonna type in dinner's ready, which is the default text. And then I'm gonna choose which HomePod I wanna broadcast it to, or I can choose all of the HomePods. Next, let's name and test the shortcut. I'm gonna call mine iPad menu and select an icon and a color for it. I'm gonna tap the play button, which is right next to it, and go through all the options to make sure they work as expected. Now, if something fails, you can check the actions linked to, and troubleshooting should be straightforward. Finally, let's go ahead and save the shortcut. I'm gonna tap the inspector window on the right-hand side. I'm gonna choose add to home. You wanna pick the color and the symbol that you're gonna use for it. And then once you do so, it's gonna save on, should be the first or second page of your iPad, and you can place it anywhere that you want to, including the dock. Now for the lock screen, you can long press on your lock screen, tap customize, and you can click on add a shortcut widget, run single widget, and then just select the name of the widget that you just created. And that's it, your custom iPad menu is ready. I've linked a template in the description that you can save and copy to your own library if you wanna start from scratch or use the one that I have. And this video is part of my tutorial series. Every week, I'm gonna share a quick iPad, iPhone, Mac tutorial, just like this one, so make sure you're subscribed if you wanna see that type of content. And if you wanna build something similar on your iPhone that works with the action button, watch this video next. Don't forget, you can always download my free iPadOS 26 setup guide. It's gonna be linked over here. It covers widgets, tweaks, features that pair perfectly with this shortcut. My name is Mike, and I'll see you in the next one.